In this video, we're going to talk about how to use an OTC fuel injector tester. We'll be using this tester to go through a fuel balance test in order to see if all our injectors have the ability to flow the same amount of fuel. To get set up for this test, I need a handful of things. First, I need my OTC fuel injector tester. This is a small control box that gives me some connection points to provide 12 volts to it, as well as make a connection to both the injector and ports for my digital volt ohm meter. I'm going to need to also set up a fuel pressure test gauge. So I've got this test gauge set up. It is hooked up to the low pressure fuel system. For this particular vehicle, I'm going to need some jumper and adapter cables that will help me get the connection of the OTC box to the fuel injector itself. The OTC box uses a pretty standard, albeit older style Bosch connector. They also do sell adapter harnesses for popular configurations and injector types. I don't have the adapter for this one, so we'll use a set of leads and small adapters to make that happen. The other thing I'll need is a set of instructions. Here at Parkland, we made the OTC instructions into a full-scale book like this. This will be my guide and my reference. I'm also opting to use a scan tool in this case to actuate the fuel pump so I don't have to go to the driver's seat and cycle the ignition switch every time I want to prime the fuel pump to gain pressure. So real quick, before we get started, let's talk about what this box does and what the test is trying to achieve. This box is capable of doing two different tests. It can do a balance test for my injectors as well as a voltage drop test. Both of those are really looking for what's the electrical capability of my solenoid, my fuel injector. That's the volt drop test to look at what is the coil saturation like, how does it react to amperage, and it's a much better test than just, say, statically checking resistance. And so there's a great test to do. The one that we're doing today is a fuel injector balance test. This test is gonna help me understand what are not only the electrical capabilities of that injector, but also what's the mechanical ability. There's really two camps, there's two jobs this injector has to do. We want it to behave and perform electrically, right? Be able to have a volt drop, have the coil saturation and current that we expect it to have to operate, but it also mechanically needs to be able to move the volume of fuel that we expect. And injectors as a group within an engine need to have similar abilities in terms of their volume. If we've got one injector on a four-cylinder like this that flows 30% more than the rest, that creates a problem because that injector and that cylinder are gonna have a much greater rich condition than the rest of the cylinders, and that's gonna lead to drivability and engine performance problems. So doing this test is gonna help me understand if I watch a specific pressure, I open the injector for a specific amount of time, and we're gonna see how much fuel pressure can it drop over a certain period of time. That's gonna help me understand what are the mechanical flow capabilities of that injector, and then I can take all that data, rank them next to each other and see, do I have some injectors that are more inherently lean or rich than the rest? And again, are they behaving well as a group? Let's talk setup. So this box has got just two connections that come out of it. I've got a connector here that needs to go to my injector in order to trigger and send voltage and current to that injector. We'll go ahead and lay that one out that way. The other connection, I need to provide 12 volts, just a power and ground. I can get that from my battery, a jump pack, really any 12 volt source, but that's gonna be the source of current and energy in order to operate my injector and open it. Once I get that plugged in, I should get a green LED here on the box. It tells me that I'm good to go, I'm ready to test, and I could test that out. Whenever I push this, it goes to test in progress. The next thing I've got to do is connect this connector to my fuel injectors. I'm going to do this one at a time, so I just need to unplug one and then figure out how to get my two leads here connected to that injector. As I mentioned in the beginning, there's some special adapter harnesses. We've even got some here that we've made. You know, you can go to the junkyard and go to places, get small pigtails from injectors and make them into test leads. I don't have one for this specific Toyota, and so we're going to use this test kit here. This is a small kit by Rotunda that's just like a little flex probe kit. I've identified the specific size here that fits on my injector, and so I'm going to insert both these, put some test leads here, and then get them out to some male terminals so I can plug them into this. I've got these two cables plugged into my adapters at the injector. I've added two other adapters here to get a connection to the test box. I don't need to worry about polarity. If I look at the instructions here, we talk about getting things set up, hooking up a gauge, making all these connections we've made, and then selecting a specific setting on the box. And so you'll see here, we got to select our amp supply based on injector resistance. So I'm going to use my DVOM here. Go ahead and get that set up for a resistance measurement. I can take my leads and I can put them in the two test ports at the top of the tool. That should then give me a reading here on my tool. It looks like these injectors are just about 13 ohms. And so I take that reading and refer back to my set of instructions. And based on that 1.8 and above, I'm gonna go to the 2.5 amp setting. So I can move my DVOM. Double check here, I'm on the balance test. So here I'm on the balance test, and I'm gonna choose 0.5 to 2.5. So here I've got most of my hardware set up for the test. I know that my OTC box is ready. I've got a gauge connected. And as mentioned before, I'm gonna use my scan tool here to turn on the fuel pump, watch my pressure go up. And the really important thing here is not so much to be concerned about exactly what pressure this gets to, but really pay attention to where are we at whenever I start this test. And so the sequence is that I'm going to pressurize the system, look for a starting point, right? So I need to turn my pump back off. I'm gonna press this button, and then I'm gonna watch where does it drop to. So I need a first reading, which is what is my pressure at now. I push my button, I look for a drop, I take a second reading. I'm gonna record those, and then we'll refer back to those at the end. All right, so I'm gonna go to my scan tool, turn the fuel pump off. We'll see that it dips just slightly. We're gonna look for a place where it kind of rests. So here we're right between 2 and 4. I'm gonna push my button. And we drop to what looks like about 29. So my first reading, I was at 43 PSI. That's gonna be my first reading. I'm gonna record this. I pushed my button, you heard it run through its process. All it does is open and close the injector at a specific duty cycle for a specific amount of time. That dropped us down to just under 30 PSI. We'll say that's about 29. So we had a first reading of 43 and we dropped to 29. So we've got one injector done. It's important that after I do that test, I need to start and run the engine. So I need to re-enable the fuel pump if I've got that disabled or changed in any way. And I need to start and run the vehicle for at least 10, 20 seconds in order to clear out that raw fuel that I just injected into that cylinder. If I repeat multiple tests and I don't clear the engine, I risk hydrolocking a cylinder or combustion chamber. So what I've got to do now is go through and repeat that test on cylinders 1, 2, and 3. We've got cylinder 4 collected. I'll get those done, and we're gonna look back through how do we analyze all this information to make some determinations about those injectors as a set. All right, so we've got all 4 cylinders done, and we're gonna look at this chart. So the OTC instruction guide outlines a way to analyze these readings. They put together a chart that looks like this, where I've got all of my cylinders laid out. I've got my first reading, which is my system pressure. My second reading, which is after the test. I'd use some math there to get the drop. How many PSI did my injector drop in that case? And then the analysis comes from averaging these readings and interpreting them. And so you see we got across all these 4, I was able to start at 43 PSI every time. And for the most part, they all registered about the same amount of drop. And so we went to 29, 27, 30, 29. And so those all resulted in similar drops at 14 PSI, 16, 13, and 14 again. So I take my highest and my lowest out of those amount of drop numbers, get rid of those, and then I average the remaining 2. Those are the instructions by OTC. That gets me an average pressure drop of 14 PSI. Next, I'm gonna take my amount of drop and difference from the average. And so I've got 0, +2, -1, and 0. So let's talk about the plus and the minus there. So I'm looking at these in terms of, did they drop more or less than what the average is? And really, I'm also just taking them straight down. 16 minus 14 is positive 2, 13 minus 14 is negative 1. In the instructions, it'll tell me that if I have a drop that's more than 1.5 PSI different from the rest, that I should repeat that injector to make sure that I did the test properly and that I didn't have a variable that affected the outcome. And they further go on to say that anything greater than a 2 PSI change reads as an issue, right? And so I've got right at that level, you'll see on cylinder number 2, we've labeled that as faulty rich, meaning that there's a variance where, as you can see from the numbers, that injector dropped more than the rest of these injectors. And we're concerned about that variance where if we've got 2 PSI or greater, that could be enough to create performance and drivability concerns. That's how we go through the process of using this OTC test box to do a fuel injector balance test. It could be a great test for port fuel injectors like this if I really want to get some quantified measurements in terms of how the injectors are performing relative to one another. This test can be somewhat labor intensive. It takes some time to get this set up. And yes, there's some other ways that I could go with my diagnostic path to learn similar information. We like reviewing this because it is a great way to get quantified results, and it is a factory test, a specialty test tool for several manufacturers.